Now that you have a basic understanding of the vulnerability management, we will introduce the concept of incident management. Incidents are errors that interrupt or reduce the quality of the business processes. The incident management process helps to quickly resolve this incident with minimal impact on the business. An organization that implements the incident management process derives dual benefits for its IT services and business.
So, what are the benefits of the incident management process for the IT services of an organization? Well, they're pretty clear. Improved monitoring allows performance against SLAs to be accurately measured. You get a more accurate recording of incidents and service requests. There's a noted elimination of lost or incorrect incidents and service requests. You end up with a more organized and efficient use of personnel for resolving incidents. One thing that's very important, you get greater availability of information of IT errors for effective management and more accurate CMDB information for ongoing audits while registering incidents. And then improved user and customer satisfaction can't be overrated.
That's true. So, what do you do when an incident has been identified? Security professionals say to go back to your security plan. As soon as an incident has been identified, invoke the incident and emergency response policy.
Right. All right. So let's go back to a previous question that we put out there. What will you do when an incident takes place? What are the next steps in handling that incident? Well, let me give a brief introduction to the incident management plan. Now, the steps involved in incident management plan are, and we've gone over them, but let's do it again: identify, analyze, gather evidence, contain further damage, work to mitigate, and work to eradicate the damage. Now, the last step in the plan is to update your policy.
That's correct. Here is a caution on incident management. Never ever take an incident lightly. It could be the tip of the iceberg. So consider the following. First, take a large attack surface into account. Second, include policies and action steps to minimize business disruption from incident. Third, provide adequate investigation, remediation, and a recovery. Very important.
Very important.